In this lecture series, I have focused on the first principles of computer vision. Since deep learning is popular today, you may be wondering if it is worth knowing the first principles of vision, or for that matter, the first principles of any field. Given a task, why not just train a neural network with tons of data to solve the task? Well, we are living in interesting times. The success of machine learning may have instilled in us a temptation to set aside first principles and rush too quickly to cast any new problem as just another application of machine learning. The remarkable advances made in machine learning may suggest that there is now a shortcut to success. Unfortunately, this success can prove to be both incomplete and unsatisfying. Given any mapping problem and enough data to train a network, it is likely you will very quickly get to a level of performance that is impressive, although not quite the performance you would like. Therein lies the problem. The last mile of getting your system to achieve the performance your application requires can prove to be a very long mile. It can also be very tedious. Today, I believe we have many highly skilled and talented researchers and practitioners spending an enormous amount of their valuable time collecting training data, tweaking network architectures, and training their networks, all to travel the last mile. Machine learning is meant to make our lives richer by giving us more time to satisfy our innate curiosity, nurture our creativity, and pursue our myriad interests. But ironically, some of us may be doing more for our machines than our machines were meant to do for us. Let me give you a simple example. Consider dropping a ball from a height. Let us say you want to know the distance the ball travels as a function of time. Well, thanks to Newton and first principles, we know that s is equal to ut plus half at squared, where u is the initial velocity of the ball and a is the acceleration due to gravity. Today, you could choose to have a machine learn the relationship between S and T. You could gather a bunch of your friends and have them drop objects from various heights. You could use a stopwatch to measure when each object hits the ground. Feed all of these measurements to a learning algorithm and have it find the relationship between S and T. Imagine the process of collecting this data. Imagine how much data you would need to get a result that is really close to Newton's equation. And consider the fact that in developing the system, you have not really learned anything new about the world you live in. So, if you're a student who is keen on building a career in a field like computer vision, my advice would be to always think about a problem using first principles. Make as much progress as you can using this approach. You will not only find it satisfying, but may also gain knowledge and insights along the way that change the way you pose problems in the future. If you arrive at a stage where first principles cannot get you to an elegant solution, but first principles seems to hint that the problem can be posed as a complex mapping problem that has a solution, it would make complete sense for you to use your favorite machine learning algorithm to perform the mapping. In short, first principles and machine learning can not only coexist in harmony, but in fact be symbiotic.